Okay, right now we have the background, right? So here we have the background and we have a ball, but it doesn't do anything right now. So we need to do a bit of coding to kickstart. And where do we put all our codes? Well, this middle section over here is where we put all the codes, all right? And all these things over here, they are our blocks which we use to do our coding. So you can see the color, well, there are many of them, and you can actually click over here on the tab light and choose what you want, drag them to the center. So well, right now let's select our little ball. So make sure your ball is selected. Anyway, by default it should be selected because it's the only sprite. I'm gonna pull this one in, which is move 10 step. Alright, and if I click this, I can see that there is a small little movement of the ball over here. Okay, so I can drag and drop. See, there's a small little movement. Okay, and I can actually click this little white color thing in the middle and I can change the number. So let's say I put 30, and now you can see it makes bigger movements. Alright, so basically the number in the center here is actually the distance. Alright, so you can see. Alright, now this isn't very interesting. Okay, I know it's not very interesting at this current moment. Alright, but bear with me. Okay, let's look for one other thing. Oh, here it is. If on edge, bounce. Alright, so now let's continue to press and press and press, and it's going to get closer and closer to the edge. And look what happened when it touched the edge. See, you will actually bounce. But this isn't much of a game, isn't it? Alright, at least not yet. Okay, so this is a condition to make it bounce, but I don't actually enjoy clicking on this all the time. So what if I can go to the control? I'm using the control here, and there is this little forever loop. Loop basically means that it will continue looping, right, doing it over and over again, and I just encase it. Now, if I were to click this, oh, I only need to do it once. How do I stop this? Well, there is this little stop button up here. So you can click this to actually stop it. So I can click this to start and click this to stop. All right. But there is this little go flag that I can use to control instead of clicking each of the code. So where is it? It is still in the event section, and you can see this little piece over here, and I'm gonna just mount it on top. Now I do not need to click here. I can actually click this little go flag and it will start, and if I click the stop, it will stop. See, start and stop. Alright, now you may realize that how come your balls doesn't go sideways, or right, it doesn't bounce as nice as this one, because you are actually moving from left to right or something like this. Okay, go back to the motion. Alright, and there is this little piece of code called point in direction. Alright, now all these blocks programming that you have done, actually they can think of them as like Lego, little Lego bricks. You can actually pull them apart. See, I can pull them apart, and I'm gonna put this right here, and I'm going to join them together again. Okay, so I'm going to have something like this. Okay, something like this, and pointing it to a direction now is 90. Okay, I'm going to double click this little section in the center, and which direction do I want it to point? See, I can actually use this dial, or I can key in the value. So if I put it at, let's say, 45 degrees, it's actually pointing this direction. Now, click go, and you should have a bouncing ball inside your game. So now you can stop, and you can start, right? And you start to see something happening in your Pong game. Right? At least we got the ball part, right, working.